Simon & Schuster Audio presents My Footprint, Carrying the Weight of the World by Jeff Garlin. Read by the author as told to Leonard Nimoy. I'm wide awake. I'm wide awake. Wide awake. I'm not sleeping. You too.
I'm going to be joined today by Mr. Leonard Nimoy. Mr. Nimoy, are you ready?
Yes. Jeff, call me Leonard.
Okay, great. Can I get you something to drink, a cookie? Do you want to use the facilities?
No, I'm really good. I'm really good. Go ahead.
Great.
Although this the stool is a little bit close.
Okay. I just wanted you near me for the full effect.
Fine.
Prologue. Wednesday, August 27th, 2008. It's the closing night of Wally at the El Capitan movie theater in Hollywood, California, and I'm walking with my wife to my car. I may have just seen Wally for the last time on the big screen. I am more moved this time than the other half dozen times that I've seen it. I still can't believe that I'm involved with such a great movie. By the way, in case you didn't know, I was the voice of the captain of the Axiom spaceship. I call the director, Andrew Stanton, all the time to thank him. What is staying with me more this time are the themes. See, now they're really getting under my skin. I think about how fat I am and how I'm always saying I'm going to lose weight. And rarely do I do anything to get it done. I think aloud to my wife. I feel bad for her for having to hear me think out loud all the time. They're not all gems, you know. I ask her why I don't do something about my poor health. Am I ever going to do something about it? Ever? My character in the movie, The Captain, realizes it's time to do something. If not now, then when? Later on that night, as I lie in bed with my mind racing, the full idea hits me. I'll write about it. And just like in Wally, I'll go green too. I'll lower my carbon footprint as I lower my personal footprint. For obvious reasons, I need to have a lighter footprint. I need to lose at least 50, if not 100 pounds. As far as my carbon footprint is concerned, I'm a recycler and I'm considerate. Other than that, I don't know shit. As much trouble as I have with my weight, I'm much more cynical about carbon changes. I'm a boy who loves his air conditioning. But I'll suck it up. I'll lose lots of weight while becoming ecologically responsible. I'll write a book about it. A friend once told me about Jose Marti, the poet and writer who led the Cuban independence movement, who once said there are three things every person should do in his or her life. Plant a tree, have a son, and write a book. I have two sons, and once I write this book, I'll plant a tree. It's all planned out. It's going to be great. Chapter 1. God bless my wife. She always calms me down. As I'm looking through our mail this morning, she says, "You're going to see something you're not going to like." And I say, "Really? What?" She pauses, gives me a knowing look, and says, "Just use it in your comedy." I start thumbing through the mail. I have received a catalog from the good people at Living XL. It's a catalog for fat people who want to stay fat and enjoy themselves. The message is basically, don't lose weight. No. All the problems that you normally have with being fat, we've got a solution. How do they know to send me a catalog? Do they have a list of fat celebrities? I open it up. The first product on offer is a three-wheel bike with a 500-pound capacity. As I look at this contraption, I'm wondering, how many 500-pound people are sitting around? Well, they're obviously sitting around, maybe even lying around. But how many of them are sitting around thinking, I so want to go biking. I just don't have the opportunity. I weigh 450. If there was only a bike that could hold my weight, then I'd have no excuse. Next up, fat ponchos. Because we know the regular poncho is so slimming. Has anyone ever put on a poncho and said, this is not freeing enough? Really, it's not. I guess the only way this thought would cross your mind is if you're a really fat woman and you're wearing a muumuu underneath your oversized poncho. Poncho and muumuu. Sounds like a new cop show. The next page features a lawnmower handle extender. I don't know what this has to do with being fat. Wait a second. Okay, it must be to allow extra room for your stomach as you're mowing. That's probably it. Now, how about one of those chairs you bring to a kid's soccer game, except this one's got an 800-pound capacity? How many 800-pounders do you see out in society? It must be for a 400-pounder who's got a 400-pound girlfriend who wants to sit on his lap. How about a 650-pound capacity sand chair? How many 650-pound people do you see at the beach? Do you ever? No, they're at home. They can't leave. What else? Okay, here's a hammock with a 600-pound capacity. Now, I don't care what you weigh. Getting on and off a hammock, it's quite difficult. I don't care if you weigh 150. Hammock mobility is hard for everyone. So you're 600 pounds. The odds of you getting on that hammock are so slight. You're going to be on the ground. You're 600 pounds. Once you do get on, you're never getting off. So it's good that it supports your weight because you're never getting up again. Let's see here. Next is the big key computer keyboard. Because Lord knows your fingers are so fat, a typical computer keyboard's not going to work for you. Here's one with a great name. It's the Pride XL Mobility Chair. I read the description, and I learned that when you press a button on the chair, instead of having to get up, the chair lifts you up. And yet they call it the Pride Mobility Chair. I think one of the first things about being a proud person is that you can stand up on your own. I'm not talking about someone in a wheelchair or someone who's been in an accident. I'm talking about when you really don't have a reason for not being able to stand up yourself. They should call it the embarrassment mobility chair, or the you've hit rock bottom mobility chair, or even the you should be ashamed mobility chair. Next up is something you've probably seen in commercials. And to me, this is so horrible and wrong. It's the Living XL wearable sleeves blanket. Now, how many times have you covered yourself in a blanket and thought, I can't get up. I can't maneuver. If only I had sleeves. It's only a matter of time until you see someone wearing this thing at the grocery store to keep warm while perusing the frozen foods aisle. My God, they've got toilets. All right, here's one. A toilet seat that's called the Big John toilet seat. And if you think I'm making this up, I'm not. 1,200-pound capacity. Can a 1,200-pound person get up and go to the bathroom, let alone sit down and read? 1,200 pounds! Who's taking a shit in that house? It's described as durable and convenient. I understand the need for durability on this one, but what makes it more convenient than other toilet seats? Oh, right! It must be for the 400-pound man with the 400-pound girlfriend who wants to sit on his lap as he goes number two, or in this case, number five. The 1,200-pound capacity toilet seat really takes the worry out of going to the John. Once you get there, there's no panicky questions like, can it hold me? Oh, yes, it can. It most certainly can. And here's another bottomed-out contraption. The pistol grip, no-bend toenail clippers. Not being able to reach your toes because of the size of your belly? I'm sorry, but that's a low point. Maybe it's not the low point. You could be wearing a blanket and clipping your toenails while taking a dump on the Big John. It's a low point just the same. But here's the moment that might be the real bottom for me. I turn the page and I look at the model who's displaying the cabin comfort inflatable pillow. And who do you think he looks like? That's right. He looks like me. When you're going through a fat catalog and you're making fun of it and you get to the last page and the model is your twin, that's your low point. It was embarrassing enough just to be sent a copy in the mail, but the fact that I look like a model in Living XL renders me speechless. I just don't know what to say. He looks just like me. Wow. I've always wanted to look like a model, but not one from the Living XL catalog. So, this is my bottom. Done! I'm not messing around anymore. I'm like the captain in Wall-E. If not now, then when? You will see a weight loss festival like you've never imagined. As I get started on this big ball of adventure, I wonder why I'm doing it. I guess I look at this book as my impetus, my motivating factor. If writing this book doesn't make me lose weight and or go green, what will? This might be my only book ever. I wish someone were writing it for me. Actually, I wish someone were losing the weight for me, too. There are times when I'm happy to sell out, just not when I'm the writer. If I'm truly responsible for something, and you have to be responsible for your own book, your name's on the cover, I have to make it the best I can. I really hope this book is great. If I do something that's good, I look at it as a failure. Oh, boy. Something happened. Something bad. Bad and self-inflicted. So here's what just happened, okay? I got distracted. I get distracted a lot. I have attention deficit disorder, you know, ADD. That's not such a huge deal. In fact, I think almost every comedian I know has ADD. It's just what happens when I get distracted that's the problem. See, I just went down to the kitchen, and I ate a huge bowl of Life cereal. I just had a big bowl of Life, literally. And therein lies the problem. Let me explain my eating disorder to give you an idea of what I'm up against. You can put me in a room, and in that room you have the best pot in the world, the best Coke in the world, the greatest glass of wine of all time, and a two-day-old grocery store sheet cake. Guess where I'm going?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.